there are a few steps you should take to prepare an expression for a preset. Number one, start in the version of After Effects you want the preset to be compatible with. Number two, remove any unused code or expressions. Number three, check your variable names to ensure they are easy to understand and edit. Number four, add comments to your expression to help understand how it functions. Number five, decide if you need any keyframes included with the preset and remove remaining keyframes. Number six, make sure the expression does not reference properties on other layers. So let's create an expression preset. In this composition, you'll notice some star layers. If you come down and highlight star 1, you can press T to open the opacity channel. So go ahead and add a new expression to opacity. You can apply a wiggle expression to change the star's opacity over time. So start with wiggle, open parenthesis, and then you can set 5 for the frequency, comma, and then I'm going to use value divided by 2 for the amplitude, close parenthesis. So if you click away from the expression, it's going to update here. I'm going to set some keyframes so it fades in over time. So I'm going to come to 1 second and set a keyframe. And then I'm going to come to the very beginning and set a keyframe at 0. And one last touch, I'm going to highlight both of these and hit F9 to create easy ease keyframes. So star 1 is located right here. And if I RAM preview the scene, you'll see it fade in and then start to flicker. So that's a pretty cool, simple animation. I'm going to take this a step further and add a slider control to the star layer. And I'm going to set this at 10. And then I'm going to click into the expression we just wrote and remove 5 for the frequency. And I'm going to drag the pick whip up to the slider control. So now if you click away from the expression, you'll notice that the frequency of flickering has changed. So this is a pretty simple animation and it's looking good. And I want to create a preset out of this. So to save this as an expression preset, I'm not only going to have to select the opacity with the expression applied, I'm also going to need the slider control because the opacity relies on that effect. So to do that, I'm going to come to star 1 in the timeline, twirl down the effects, slider control, and control or command click on the slider effect. Now this is going to select both properties and it's ready to create a preset. Now let's say I didn't want the keyframes included here. I could just shift and lasso these to remove them from the selection. But in this case, I want them. Now in the After Effects top level menu, I'm going to go to Animation, Save Animation Preset at the very top. Now this window is going to pop up and it's asking me where I'd like to save this preset. I want to make sure I'm in the User Presets folder. Now the name that you give this file is going to be the same name that shows up in Effects and Presets. So I'm going to call this file fade and wiggle. And then I'm going to come down and hit save. So now the preset is successfully saved and you can actually find it in the file explorer by going to documents, Adobe, After Effects, and the version you're in and the user presets folder. And so here you can see the fade and wiggle preset that I just created. So you can copy this file to other computers. Just make sure those computers are running the same version of After Effects you're in or later. Now, if you go back to After Effects and go into Animation Presets, you don't even need to restart After Effects for this to show up. So this is the preset we just created, and I want to use it to apply the same effect to stars 2 through 12. Now I'm going to move forward 2 seconds in time so that you can see how the preset is applied to the other layers. So I'm going to hit T on the keyboard just so I can see the opacity properties here. And then I'm going to come over to the Effects and Presets window and double click on the fade and wiggle preset. Now immediately you've seen all of these star layers go to 0 opacity and they've all been given a slider control. So if I click into one, star 2, it has a slider control set to 10, just like our original. Now if I twirl down the opacity, you'll see the expression matches the one we created on the first layer. And because my playhead was at 2 seconds instead of at the beginning, all the keyframes started at 2 seconds. So I'm going to hit U on the keyboard to collapse everything up. And now if you RAM preview the scene, you'll see the first star come in, and then the other 11 stars come in, and they're all twinkling. Pseudo effects combine multiple sliders and value controls. The benefits of using pseudo effects are their clean and professional look, extra features that normal controls don't have, and the ability to set default values. These aren't expressions themselves, but they make life easy when it comes to cleaning up a complex template and linking expressions to a large number of controls. Keep in mind, Pseudo Effects have limited compatibility in older versions of After Effects. Now there are a couple ways to create Pseudo Effects for your project. Let's take a look at the first way to create them using an XML file. To get started, locate the PresetEffects.xml file inside of your After Effects directory. On Windows, this is going to be your C drive, program files, Adobe, your version of After Effects, support files, and then scroll down the page until you find the PresetEffects.xml. For Mac, this is going to require you to go to Applications, your current After Effects version, and then right-click the After Effects app file, select Show Package Contents, and then navigate to Contents, Resources, and PresetEffects.xml. It's a pretty good idea to create a backup file of this preset effects before you start modifying it, so I'm going to copy it and then save it to another directory. Now that I've created a backup of this file, I'm going to open it with a text editor. So I'm going to double-click, and it's going to open in Sublime Text. Now this is a pretty big file that stores lots of pseudo effect content for After Effects. I'm going to scroll down to the very bottom of the page. If you're watching this tutorial online, you'll find a link to copy and paste the example XML in the video description. If you've downloaded the project files, you can find an example XML file in the resources folder next to the project files. Once you've found the XML file, open it up in the text editor of your choice. So this is the example file, and this is the pseudo effect. It starts with an effect tag and includes nested sliders, checkboxes, and other controllers that you might be familiar with. And it includes a new feature, pop-up, that's only available in the pseudo effect. So first, you want to select the entire code block, including the indentation, and you want to copy this code. So I'm going to hit Control or Command C, and then come over to the PresetEffects.xml file. So come to the end of the tag and hit Enter to create a new line. And I'm going to backspace at the beginning and then paste the pseudo effect. Now inside of this is just an example block with all of the possibilities that you can use. Feel free to duplicate things. You can have more than one slider, more than one checkbox. You can rename them here, and you can rename your controller here. You'll notice that each line represents a control of a different type. So this is a slider, and then it's given a name with some After Effects specific syntax. And then the actual slider's name is custom slider name. So you can change this, and then you can set a default value here. Valid values are the absolute min and max that a value can go. Nothing can exceed these values, not even an expression. The slider min and slider max values are the maximum amount of value that the slider can manually slide. The precision property specifies how many decimal places to show after the value. Now you also have properties like checked, false, or true. You have default RGB values. A group can be named, and then inside of that group there can be other properties. Or you can create a 3D point with a default X, Y, and Z value. Now there are some issues with compatibility for the point 3D, so be careful when using that. You also have an angle control, which is the same as After Effects and can set a default rotation. And finally, the new feature that XML allows is the pop-up control. So this is very similar to a layer control where you have a drop-down menu, but the only difference with this is you can set the custom options. So it defaults to the first option, which is going to be choose an option as the text. And then inside of the pop-up string, you can specify the options separated with a pipe symbol. So for example, choose an option is option 1, selection A will be option 2, B option 3, C option 4, and so on. Now the cool part about this is if you reference this with an expression, whenever a user chooses an option, so for example, if they choose selection A, that's going to output a number 2. So you can set conditional statements to say, if the pop-up's value is 2, do this action. If it's 3, do this action. So if you've noticed, I haven't modified anything with this pseudo effect, but as is, it's ready to go. I don't have to change anything. I can change the names if I want to, but I'm just going to leave them for now. And now we'll look at applying it in After Effects. So the next step is going to be saving this document. So I'm going to close this out, and I'm going to leave this document open because we need the last line of text for the next step. Now you'll have to close After Effects, so I'm going to do that now. And now we're back open with a fresh copy of After Effects. So you've saved the XML file and you have the controller ready to go. How do we actually get it into After Effects? Well, the easiest way to do this is to run a custom script from the editor in After Effects. So to access this, you want to go to the top level File menu and come all the way down to Scripts and Open Script Editor. Now clicking this launches the script editor and then it gives you a blank window. Now this is where that last line comes into play. So I'm going to select this line and Control or Command C to copy, and then I'm going to open the script editor and I'm going to paste into the window here. Now mine's good to go because I didn't rename my controller, but if you've renamed this in the XML, which you'll see right here, your custom control V1, make sure this matches this inside of your preset effects XML file. So mine is the same, I'm going to leave it. And now all you have to do is hit this little green button to start running the script. Now I see here that the execution is finished, and now I can go back to After Effects. So here's the custom pseudo effect, and here's the group with more options. Now this pseudo effect is the visual representation of this block of code. So if I come back over to After Effects, this is a closer look at the pop-up. They can select any of these options, and whichever one they select will output that number. So this will output 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. There's one more thing I should note. If you look closely at the script at the very end here that actually applied our pseudo effect, it's grabbing the first layer in the composition and then adding the property. Now if you were to run this exact same script with this current composition, you would get an error because the camera cannot have an effect. So you'd either need to move the control above the camera or change this to layer 2. That's how you create a custom control, insert it into the preset effects XML file, and import it into After Effects using the script editor. The simpler and easier technique of creating a pseudo effect is to use the Pseudo Effect Maker plugin created by Batchframe Software on aescripts.com. Once you install the plugin, you can begin creating your pseudo effect without typing a single line of code. So first things first, you want to open the plugin by going to Window, Extensions, Pseudo Effect Maker. Once you click this, it's going to open in a new window. You can dock it if you'd like. So this is your default pseudo effect. You have these clean controls here where you can apply each of them to your pseudo effect, and you'll see them pop up right here. Now we could create something like this over here, so I could create a slider, and then I could put a checkbox underneath it, and then I could create a color, and then a pop-up, and a group, and then inside of this group, it's currently empty, but I could drag something into it, so I could grab this checkmark, drop it into the group. You can click into each of these names and rename them, so I can name this custom group. I could name this checkbox, my checkbox, and I could set a value over here to something like 1. And this is a new feature that a normal checkbox doesn't allow you to do. You can also select something like the pop-up here, and right now there's a couple default options, but you can come over here and change them just by creating new lines. So I could start with option 1, enter, option 2, enter, option 3. One last thing, I'm just going to rename this My New Effect. So I'm happy with this effect. Now I just need to make sure that the layer I want to apply it to is selected in the timeline. So Control already has one, but it can accept another. So I'm just going to highlight Control in the timeline and hit Apply. So it's translated this pseudo effect and it gives us all of our options. And this is a completely usable pseudo effect. Now if you want to save this pseudo effects for quick application or if you want to edit it later, you can save it as an FFX file in the same presets folder. So if I save this as pseudo effect and hit save, and so now if you have a blank window here, you can go to open and you can select it right here. And it brings all of your options right back where they were. Another cool feature, you can come over here and hit copy XML. And it's going to take this pseudo effect and translate it into XML code like the code we had before. So if I navigate back to Sublime and select the existing pseudo effect and paste, it's now given us the new pseudo effect. It's also including a warning message here telling you about incompatible effects. So this block of code has a checkbox label, which is right here. And this label will not show up if you're applying this through the PresetEffects.xml file. It only works with Pseudo Effect Maker. So I'm going to undo this paste, and I'm going to select our existing pseudo effect. Now I'm going to copy it to the clipboard and go back to After Effects. And just like we copied a pseudo effect, we can also paste in a pseudo effect from XML. So if I select this option, now we have our original control from earlier. Now once a pseudo effect is created, you can copy it to other layers. So I can select this pseudo effect, copy, come down to Planet, and paste, and it'll work fine. You can also move this to other project files, other computers, and there's no need for the Pseudo Effect Maker plugin to be installed on that machine. This is a great tool for template makers and gives your files a much more professional look. There's also a great video tutorial on the product download page on aescripts.com that walks you through the steps to create these pseudo effects. The process of linking an expression to a pseudo effect is identical to linking to an expression control. It just replaces slider control slider with pseudo effect pseudo property in your expression. So if you wanted to link the planet scale to the pseudo effect we created earlier, you can just add an expression to scale and then highlight control so we can see the pseudo effect in the effect controls panel, and then grab the expression pick whip, come up and drag it to custom slider name. Now when you let go, it's going to create a three-dimensional array, and it's going to reference your custom control name, which is the effect up here, and then custom slider name, which is the slider here. Now it's currently set to 0, which is why the scale is at 0, but I can bring this up to 100 and hit enter, and now the planet follows suit. So this slider is the same as a regular slider control, it just has a little bit more customization. We've arrived at the end of lesson 404, creating presets and pseudo effects to control expressions. If you enjoy this expressions course, consider purchasing the paid content. It includes in-depth documentation, extra tutorial content, high-definition videos, and all the project files used in the training. Your purchase will help to create more free courses like this in the future.